Welcome back, guys. We're going to work on a hamstring flow for you today. So we're going to start in a kneeling position. So bring your toes underneath. Sit bones, have the heels facing up. And just take a few moments here to allow the bottoms of the feet and toes stretch out. And so even though we're working on those hamstrings, the backs of the legs, it's all connected. So we're just going to allow the bottoms of the feet, the toes to stretch out. I know a lot of us hold tension, have very tight bottoms of the feet. Just spend a few moments here, maybe not to close down the eyes. Just feeling how tight the bottoms of your feet are. If it's really too much tension, you can bring some weight forward onto the thighs or onto the floor. But try and stay here a little bit longer than you want to. Using your breath to soften into the feet, the toes. Let it all stretch out. Take a nice deep breath in through the nose. Relax the shoulders on the breath out. We'll take three more breaths here. Softening into those feet. Let the feet stretch. Let them relax a little bit more. One more breath. Slowly sliding the hands forward, coming into a tabletop position to release the toes, squeeze the toes and tap the feet out. And then we're going to lay onto our back. So shift the hips down to one side. Now for this next bit, if you've got a strap or a belt or a towel, or a band like we have, grab one now. Laying onto our backs. Now have the feet flat on the mat. And we're going to lift the right leg up to bring the knee up towards. Point the toe up towards the ceiling. And just make some circles with the ankle. Noticing how the backs of the legs, the hamstrings feel. Go one way, then the other. And then bend the knee towards the chest and using your strap to place kind of just underneath the balls of the feet. And then strap. knees, place the palms down. I'm going to step back to downward facing dog. So stepping the feet back. The downward dog's a great stretch for the back of the body. So if you need to, bend the knees. Otherwise, straighten the legs, looking towards the knees, looking through the knees, sinking the heels back. And then let's pedal out those legs. So pushing through the heel, bending the knees, side to side, stretching down the backs of those legs. Really focus on pushing through the heel rather than bending the knee. Push through that heel. And then bring it back to the center. Just take a moment here. Three deep breaths. In and out through the nose. And then start to lift the heels up, squeeze in the calves. Exhale, lower through the heels. And again, inhale, rising up. Exhale to lower the heels. Use that breath. Inhale, rise. Last one. Exhale, soften the legs, sink into the stretch. And then start to walk the feet towards the hands. Nice and slow, coming to our dangling pose, feet hip distance. Inhale to lengthen through the spine. Exhale, folding over the legs. Soft bend in those knees. Allow the tummy to come to the thighs. And then let the back stretch out as well. As I said, it's all connected into the lower back, the glutes. Just relax the head. Gentle stretch over the back of the body. Spread the ball to the feet, the toes. Shifting the weight forward and towards the toes. Feel the difference in the stretch down the back of the legs. And then gently rocking back to the center. And see if you can lift the toes up off the floor. Use your breath to get more relaxed and deeper into the stretch. And then rocking back towards the heels. See if you can lift the balls of the feet up off the floor. And then placing the balls of the feet, the toes back down. Come back to the center. Just take three more deep breaths here. Relax the head, the shoulders. The breath is really key for our stretching. It helps us relax our nervous system to allow us to get into these positions. One more breath here. And then we're going to inhale to our halfway lift. So placing the fingertips on the floor or hands on the shins. And inhale, lift the chest. Straighten those legs. And then exhale to fold. Bend the knees slightly. Folding back down to dangling pose. And again, inhale to lift. Fingertips on the floor or hands on the shins. Lift the chest. Straighten those legs as much as you can. Exhale to fold. One last time. Inhale to lift. Straighten those legs. Draw the tummy in. Nice. Exhale to fold. We're going to step back the right leg into a pyramid stance. So just a short stance. Step the right foot back, keeping the hips forward. Walking those fingertips back. Now, if it's too tight down the back of the leg, you can't get the fingertips on the floor, grab some cushions, some books, or some blocks to hold your hands up here. Otherwise, looking towards the shin, draw the right hip forward, sink your tummy down towards the thigh, folding over that front leg, trying to relax the front leg, allowing it to stretch down the back of the leg. If it's too much, come out of the stretch a little bit. You want to soften into it, allow your body to get deeper and deeper over time, using the breath. So never go in at your max. Ease yourself into the position. Nice deep breath in. Feel it up all the way into the belly. And then exhale, soften over that leg. Take one more deep breath here. And then we're going to step that right foot back a bit further, bending into the front leg, coming into a low lunge. Keeping the hands on the floor. Send that back foot back. Try to straighten that back leg. Hold it here. I'm going to gently rock backwards and forwards. Easing ourselves into the position. Relaxing the hips. Remember, we're focusing on the backs of the legs. Think about the left leg. breathe out, lower that back knee down. And then walking the hands back. We're going to straighten that front leg. Keeping the tummy towards the thigh, pointing the toe to start with. Bringing that right hip forward in line, or sending that left hip back. And then start to lift the toes up towards you. Flexing in that foot. Take a nice deep breath into lengthen through the spine. And then exhale, folding over that leg a little bit lower. Again, don't go in at your max. Just find a nice stretch. Hold it there. Use your breath. Every time you breathe out, sink in a little bit lower. If you want, you can relax that front foot to allow the leg to relax a bit more. Nice deep breath in. As you breathe out, soften a little bit lower. Now notice how your body's positioned, especially the right leg. Because you can go really low down here with a position like this. Let's come up a little bit, slide the front foot forward, and try and have the right knee under the right hip. And try again here. Might hit a slightly different part of the leg. Again, you can either point the toe or flex the foot. Maybe you want to make some circles with that front ankle just to really feel into where you need the stretch. And then find some stillness. Inhale to lengthen through the spine. Try not to round the back. Again, here you can use some blocks, some books, whatever you've got, cushions, to keep your spine nice and lengthened out and not rounding the back. Exhale, folding over that leg a little bit lower. And then we're going to bring ourselves up, so nice and slow. Bring ourselves up and bend into that front leg. Now you want to see if you can slide that foot forward, keeping the fingertips on the floor, or if you can go down to the palms. Wiggle that foot as far forward as you can. Keep length through the spine and hold it here. If you can go all the way down to the palms for a bit more support with the arms, go ahead. Hold it here, relax the back foot. If you need support for that back knee, you can always get a cushion under there or double up your mat. You can fold the mat over if you need support for that back knee. And then just hold it here. Now if you've got a front split in your practice, feel free to slide that foot all the way forward and the back knee back. Otherwise, holding it here wherever you feel good. If you've got your splits, try to walk the hands back towards the body and hold it here. Take a nice deep breath in and out. Soften into that stretch. Play around with maybe pointing the toe if you can, or drawing the toes back. Gently easing yourself into the position. Listening to your body. If it's too much, come out slightly. Use your breath to deepen into the stretch. Now to take one more breath here. So you slide that front foot back, bring the back knee in a little bit, coming back up nice and slow, unless you're stuck. Slide that back front foot in. Nice. Bring yourself back up. We're going to step back into a pyramid. So tuck the back toes, lifting up the back knee, stepping back into a pyramid. Feel that blood flowing into the leg. Take a nice deep breath in here to lengthen. Notice if you feel any different on this leg, hopefully a bit more stretched out. Exhale, folding over the leg. See if you can draw your head towards the shin. One more breath here. And then walking the fingers forward, coming back to a forward fold. Step that back foot in. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale to fold. And let's rise all the way back up, just to notice the difference. Palms together, inhale, rising all the way back up. Palms back in towards the chest, shake out the legs. Noticing the difference between the left and right. We're going to go on to the other side. So when you're ready, let's fold all the way back down. Forward fold. Inhale to halfway lift. Exhale, fold. And again, we'll do two more lifts. So inhale, lift up. Maybe the fingertips on the mat, maybe the hands on the shins. You want to straighten the legs, lift the chest. Exhale, fold. One more time. Inhale to lift. Exhale, fold. Stepping back into our pyramid. The left leg goes back. Short stance. Inhale to lengthen. And
exhale, folding over that front leg. Looking towards the shin, keeping length through the spine. Bringing that left hip forward if you can, and shifting the right hip back. A few breaths here. If you get your palms all the way down, if you want support, it's better to have the palms down to make you feel a bit more stable, control the stretch a bit more. Otherwise, strengthening up those fingertips is always great. Use your breath, relaxing a little bit more on the exhale. One more breath here. And then bending into that front knee, we're going to send the left leg back a bit wider, coming down into a lunge. And then rocking backwards and forwards gently. Again, focusing on the back of the right leg. So leaning backwards and forwards. Stretching out. Gently find some stillness here for a breath. And then we're going to lower that back knee down. Lower the knee down. Bring yourself up to straighten that front leg. Walking the hands back. And you can start with the bum back if you want to, like you did on the other side. Pointing the toe. And then drawing the toes back towards the body, pushing through the heel. Think about those hips. Bringing that left hip forward a little bit. Drawing the right hip back. Inhale to lengthen the spine. Exhale, folding over that leg. Trying not to round the back. Drawing the tummy in. If you want, you can relax that foot. Focusing on stretching the back of the leg. Relax the head down. Nice deep breath in and out. And then again, bringing yourself back up. Having the left hip over the knee. If you need support, again, fold the mat or put a cushion under your knee. Go again, walk that foot forward and straighten the front leg. So you're a bit more upright. Use your palms to support if you can reach, or again, the fingertips. Inhale to lengthen, exhale, folding over that leg. Relax the foot. Take three deep breaths here. And then bringing yourself up, placing the foot down, and wiggle that front foot forward. So relaxing the back toes, wiggle that front foot forward, keeping length through the spine, maybe taking the back knee back, just holding it here wherever you feel comfortable. Don't push it too far, go within your limits. Nice deep breath in and out. If you've got your full split, go all the way into as much as you want to. Maybe you want to walk the hands back towards the body. Hold it here, nice. Better on that side, yeah?
Yeah, left side.
Generally we have one bent side, don't we, normally? But if you notice that, try and bring it into balance. So spend a little bit longer on the side that's a bit tighter. Use your breath to try to relax the nervous system, allowing the sensory receptors to relax and let you get deeper into the stretch. Nice slow, deep breath in through the nose. Control the breath on the way out. Trick your brain to thinking you're comfortable here. Take a nice deep breath in and out. And then slowly bring that front foot back towards you. Coming out of a stretch, nice and slow. Bring the back knee in. Coming all the way back here. Nice. We're going to step back into our pyramid. Bring the hands in front. Tuck the back toes. Step your foot back into the pyramid. Straight legs. Noticing the difference now after doing those stretches from the last pyramid. Folding over the leg. Head towards the shin if you can. Try not to round the back. Adjust your hips. Try to get them in line. Back to that breath. One more deep inhale and exhale. And then stepping the back foot forward. Inhale to halfway lift. Exhale to fold. Inhale to lift. Exhale to fold. One more lift. Straighten those legs as much as you can. Exhale, fold, and then palms together, slowly rising all the way back up to the center.
Ooh. Notice how those legs feel. Thumbs up in towards the chest, gently bending into those legs. Nice. We're going to come back down to the floor. So when you're ready, slowly lower down, bend the knees, sink the bum all the way down. Use your hands for support if you need to. Coming all the way back down to our back, we're going to grab our strap one last time. If you don't want to use the strap here, you might want to try to grab it back to the thigh. So either you can place the strap there, or your towel, whatever you have, just below the back to the knee. So above the back to the knee, and then grab the back of the thigh. Left foot's on the floor. We're going to do a bit of PNF here. We're going to push the thigh into the hand and pull the strap or pull the thigh towards you. So we're going to hold. back to the crossed leg, palm back towards the chest. And thank you all so much for joining me. Namaste.
Namaste.
How's the legs?
Good, amazing.
Hope you can walk.
That's fine. Needed that.